Okay, lights out. This is the center spot we're looking at now, almost the center. Slight increase there. This is slightly off center toward the 1-2 side. It's some type of abrasion or something in the ground where the pine needles are all pushed back, and we get a high reading about the deflection of 2 to 3, maybe 4, depending on the point of it.
Yes. So there's a positive after effect?
Yes, there is definitely.
That's on the center spot. There is an after effect.
What does that mean?
When the lights are turned off, once we are focused in and allow time for the eyes to adjust, we are getting an indication of a heat source coming out of that center spot, as which will show up on
the heat or some form of energy. It's hardly heat at this stage of the game.
Looking directly overhead, one can see an opening in the trees plus some freshly broken pine branches on the ground underneath.
Looks like someone came off about 15 to 20 feet up. Some small branches about an inch or less in diameter. Zoom 148, we're hearing very strange sounds out of the farmer's barnyard animals. It's very, very active, making an awful lot of noise.
There wasn't a pigmentation.
You just saw a light where? Where?
Right in this position here, straight ahead in between the tree. There it is again.
Watch.
Straight ahead off my flash right there. So there it is.
Hey, I see it too. What is it?
We don't know, sir.
So you have a giant over there. Yeah, it's a strange, small red light. Looks to be out maybe a quarter to half mile, maybe further out. I'm going to switch off. The light is gone now. It was approximately 120 degrees from the site. Is it back again?
Yes, sir.
Oh, that's the flashlight set. Let's move out to the edge of the clearing so we can get a better look at it. See if you can get the star scope on it. The light's still there, and all the barnyard animals have gotten quiet now. You know, we're heading about 110 to 120 degrees from the site out through to the clearing now. Still getting a reading on the meter, about 2 clicks. Meter's jumped 3 to 4 clicks, getting stronger.
Now it's coming up. Hold up, there we go. It's about approximately 4 foot off the ground. It's come to the center of 110 degrees.
All right, just turn the meter off. You've got to say that again. About 4 feet off the ground, about 110 degrees, getting a reading of about 4 clicks.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, but
now it's dying.
Now it's dying. I think it's something other than the ground. I think it's something that's something very
more. It's on the tree right over.
We just found the first night bird we've seen. We're about 150 or 200 yards from the site. Everything else is just deathly calm. There is no doubt about it. There's some type of strange flashing red light ahead.
There's yellow.
I saw a yellow tinge in it, too. Weird. It appears that he may be moving a little bit this way. It's brighter than it has been.
Yellow.
It's coming this way.
Also,
it is definitely coming this way. Pieces of it are shooting off. There is no doubt about it. This is weird.
To the left.
Yeah, definitely moving to the left.
Two lights. One light to the front,
okay.
One light to the left.
Keep flashlights off. Here's something very, very strange. Keep the headset on. See if it gets any stronger. Okay. Give us your
weather notation. This is on a beta reading, too.
It's on a beta reading?
Beta
okay.
Shield has been removed.
Okay. Pieces are falling off it again.
And it just moved to the right.
Yeah.
Off to the right.
Strange. Oh, well, right on the left. Let's approach to the edge of the woods up there. Can you undo it out lights? Let's do it carefully. Come on. Okay, we're looking at the thing. We're probably about 200 to 300 yards away. It looks like an eye winking at you. It's still moving from side to side. And when you put the star scope on it, it sort of has a hollow center, a dark center. It's like a pupil of an eye looking at you and winking. And the flash is so bright to the star scope that it almost burns your eye. We passed the farmer's house and across into the next field. Now we have multiple sightings of up to 5 lights with a similar shape and all, but they seem to be steady now rather than a pulsating or glow with a red flash. We just crossed the creek. And we're getting what kind of readings now? Getting 3 good clicks on the meter, and we're seeing strange lights in the sky. Two further, we're at the far side of the second farmer's field, and made sighting again about 110 degrees. This looks like it's clear out to the coast. It's right on the horizon. Moves about a bit and flashes from time to time. Still steady or red in color. Also, after negative readings in the center of the field, we're picking up the slight readings, 4 or 5 clicks now on the meter. 3 or 5, we see strange strobe-like flashes to the rather sporadic, but there's definitely something, some kind of phenomenon.
305 at about 10 degrees horizon directly north. We've got two strange objects, half moon shape, dancing about with colored lights on them. But guess to be about 5 to 10 miles out, maybe less. The half moons have now turned into full circles. I know there was an eclipse or something there for a minute or two. 0315, now we've got an object about 10 degrees directly south, 10 degrees off the horizon. And the ones in the north are moving, one's moving away from us.
Moving out fast.
This one on the right heading away, too.
Yeah, we're both heading north. Okay. Hey, here he comes from the south. He's coming toward us now. Now we're observing what appears to be a beam coming down to the ground. This is unreal. 330, and the objects are still in the sky, although the one to the south looks like it's losing a little bit of altitude. We're turning around and heading back toward the base. The object to the south is still beaming down lights to the ground. 0400 hours, one object still hovering over Woodbridge Base at about 5 to 10 degrees off the horizon, still moving erratic and similar lights and beaming down